So, good afternoon students. So, we are going to start today's class. We were discussing the chapter Microbes in Human Welfare, right? Up to a certain extent, we have completed in the last class. So, today what we are left out is, we are left out with the last portion of the lesson, right? So, most probably, we are going to complete the lesson today. So, what we will be talking about is microbes as a biocontrol agent, microbes as biofertilizers, and obviously we have to talk about that sea waste treatment that we have just said a few things about the sea waste treatment in the last class, right? So up till now what we have read is we have talked about microbes, and what we know is not necessary microbes will always have a negative impact, right? There are many useful things that we have to know about microbes, and they are always useful for us. So what we have read is we have read about the role of microbes in household products, in the preparation of industrial products like beverages, antibiotics, etc. Right? We have talked about the formation of household products like curd, right? We have talked about idli batter, then we have talked about cheese formation, we have talked about alcohol with distillation, without distillation, the products that are formed, etc., etc. So we are going to start the class today with microbes as biocontrol agents. Means there are certain types of microbes or microorganisms which helps us in this field also. So first two points that you need to remember is ladybird control aphids and dragonflies control the growth of mosquitoes. So this is just two points that you need to remember. Next, talking about the different types of microbes that are used to control, we have to talk about first one, that is BT or Bacillus thuringiensis, right? Whenever we are talking about this, the most important point that we remember is something called as BT cotton, right? We have a variety of cotton, and that is what is called as BT cotton. Now, what is BT cotton? In a cotton plant, if suppose this gene has been incorporated, that type of plant would be called as BT cotton. Tar mane BT gene to thaka cotton gosdal, that is what is called as BT cotton, right? Now this Bacillus thuringiensis is available in the form of some spores. Kisman dry spores or nisnake available hoy. A spores bilak, what you do is mix it with water, and then this mixture is spread on the plants. Right? So, ekhinire ami ki koribo laibo? Ami biocontrol koribo laibo, no? Biocontrol mane ki? Ami enukadal plant ase, jundal plant ot suppose eta insect e infect kore. Aru he ami he infection tu ba he insect e jate infect no kore, he bostu tu ami ki koribo laibo? Stop koribo laibo. One example is the BT gene. So what we know is, as I said, this is available in the form of some spores. Hey spores bilak ami panit mix koru, aru mixture to hey plant dalot ami spray koru. Once the mixture is sprayed on that plant, jete insects bilak ahibo hey gos dala upor poribole, that mixture goes inside the insect body and it attacks the gut of the insect, and as a result hey toxin to kole humai jay, petole humai jay, and ultimately the insect dies. And if the insect dies, obviously the plant remain safe. So this is one way of controlling or preventing the plant from that insect infection, right? So the first is about Bacillus thuringiensis. Is very important from the entrance point of view. BT cotton or details aku ami eta belek chapter details out korim, right? Next is we have Trichoderma, right? Trichoderma is nothing but a free living fungi, free living symbiotic. I think we understand all this, no? Kabar logot jodi association or thake tete hale ami ki boli kom, symbiotic association or thakibo, aru jodi okole okole thake, that is what is called as free living, right? So what is Trichoderma? Trichoderma is a free living fungi. It is common in root ecosystems. So generally it infects the ki roots, right? Mati tolot thaka bostu. Next is what is important from this point is this one. The Trichoderma microorganism tur pura eta immunosuppressing agent by eta medicine produce kora hoy, and what is the name of that? It is like cyclosporin A. So yar upor question ahe, eta question ki ahe je cyclosporin A act as immunosuppressing agent. Second question is cyclosporin A is derived from, it is derived from Trichoderma, and what is Trichoderma? An example of a fungi. Right? Arrows it is specifically kobo bisarisa. It's an example of a free living fungi. So a point of very important thing is it's derived from it immunosuppressing. Now, what we understand by the word immunosuppressing? Immunosuppressing agent mane ki? So jedi ezon এজন মানুহৰ বা এটা অৰ্গেনিজিমৰ বডিৰ নিজৰ কি থাকে, এটা ইমিউনিটি থাকে ন, আমাৰবিলাকৰ কি আছে, এটা ইমিউনিটি আছে। সেই ইমিউনিটি মানে কি, যে যিকোনো এটা যদি ডিজিজ হয় আমাৰ নিজৰ বডিটোৱে উইল ট্ৰাই টু প্ৰিভেণ্ট ডেট ডিজিজ, উইল কিল ডেট বেক্টেৰিয়া ডেট এণ্টাৰ্ড ইনচাইড আছ। ফৰ এক্সাম্পল, ইফ ছাপ'জ আমাৰ তাত কি হৈছে, বেক্টেৰিয়েল ইনফেকশ্যন হৈছে বা ভাইৰেল ইনফেকশ্যন হৈছে, স্পেচিয়েলি ইফ ইয়াৰ টকিং এবাউট বেক্টেৰিয়েল ইনফেকশ্যন, তেতিয়া কি হয় যে আমাৰ বডিৰ যোনটো ইমিউন ছিষ্টেম, সেই ইমিউন ছিষ্টেমে কি কৰে যে ইট ট্ৰাইজ টু কিল দ্য বেক্টেৰিয়া অল বাই ইট ছেল্ফ। যদি নোৱাৰে দেন অবভিয়াছলি উই হেভ টু গ' ফৰ মেডিচিনছ, বাট এট দ্য ফাৰ্ষ্ট ষ্টেপ হোৱাট ডাজ ইট ডু, ইট ট্ৰাইজ টু কিল দেট বেক্টেৰিয়া অন ইটছ অ'ন, ৰাইট? দেট ইজ হোৱাট ইজ কল্ড ইজ ইমিউনিটি, ৰাইট? দেৰ আৰ চাৰ্টেন পেচেণ্টছ, কিছুমান পেচেণ্টৰ, আই থিংক ইউ হেভ হাৰ্ড সামথিং কল্ড এজ অৰ্গেন ট্ৰান্সপ্লেণ্ট, ৰাইট? কিডনি ট্ৰান্সপ্লেণ্ট কৰে ন, ইট ইজ সামথিং দেট ইজ ভেৰি কমন নাও ডেজ, আমি শুনাই পাইছোঁ। চ' অৰ্গেন ট্ৰান্সপ্লেণ্ট কৰা মানে কি, অৰ্গেন ট্ৰান্সপ্লেণ্ট কৰিলে কি হয় যে এটা এজন বেলেগ মানুহৰ অৰ্গেন এটা আনি পেলাই বেলেগ এজন মানুহৰ তাত তুমি দি দিয়া। Now that organ that you have brought from some other person might not be suitable for you, right? junjon manhor tat ami humai disu ejonor suppose ami eta organ ani ejonor tat humai disu ejonor body tot ki koribo pare se since it's a foreign substance or it's a foreign organ it might not accept it ar jodi accept nokore various types of tahador disease ba jor hoi thakibo ba they will try to compete among themselves nijor body ar foreign organ to compete koribo right hei karone ki kora hoy je organ jete transplant kora hoy junjon manhor sor ba suppose murtar organ transplant প্লেণ্ট কৰিছে তেতিয়াহ'লে আই উইল বি পুট ইন টু চাৰ্টেন টাইপছ অফ মেডিচিনছ ইন উইচ ডেট উইল ডিক্ৰিজ মাই ইমিউনিটি, মোৰ ইমিউনিটিটো বন্ধ কৰি দিব। কাৰণ মোৰ যদি ইমিউনিটি প্ৰচেছটো ভালকৈ চলি থাকে তেতিয়াহ'লে মই ফৰেন অৰ্গেন এটা মোৰ বডিয়ে কেতিয়াও একচেপ্ট নকৰে। চ' ইমিউনো ছাপ্ৰেছিং এজেণ্ট মিনছ মাই ইমিউনিটি হেজ বিন ছাপ্ৰেছড। And what is the reason for that? Because my body has to accept a foreign organ, right? And who does it? Certain types of medicines act as an immunosuppressing agent. And whenever we are talking about this, we have to talk about cyclosporin A. So question to hetu ya hai, cyclosporin A act as an immunosuppressing agent. I think we understood, right? Next is talking about the list of microbial control. The third is the name of a virus that is called as baculovirus. And whenever we talk about virus, we have to talk about its genetic material also. Kisuman virus ki hoy, single stranded hoy, kisuman double stranded hoy, kisuman single stranded DNA, double stranded DNA, single stranded RNA, etc., etc., right? So we are talking about a virus that is baculovirus. Ar iare tomar genetic material to ki hoy, it is DS DNA. It belongs to the genus that is called as nucleopolyhydrovirus, NPV. কেতিয়াবা জাষ্ট মেক্সিঙৰ কাৰণে আহিব পাৰে যে বেকিউলোভাইৰাছ বিলংছ টু উইথ জেনাছ, ইট বিলংছ টু এন পি ভি। নেক্সট, বেকিউলোভাইৰাছে কি কৰে, ইট এটেক দ্য ইনচেক্ট এণ্ড পেষ্ট, ৰাইট? অবভিয়াছলি উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট বায়ো কণ্ট্ৰল। বায়ো কণ্ট্ৰল মানে কি, যে বায়লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজিম এটা লৈ পেলাই আমি আনটো বায়লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজিম যদি কণ্ট্ৰল কৰিব পাৰোঁ, ডেট ইজ হোৱাট ইজ কল্ড এজ বায়ো কণ্ট্ৰল, ৰাইট? চ' উই আৰ ইউজিং দিছ ভাইৰাছ, দিছ ভাইৰাছ ইজ এ বায়লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজিম, এণ্ড উইথ দ্য হেল্প অফ দিছ বায়লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজিম উই আৰ প্ৰিভেণ্টিং হোৱাট আনাডাৰ বায়লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজিমছ লাইক ইনচেক্টছ এণ্ড পেষ্ট, এণ্ড দিছ ইজ হোৱাট ইজ কল্ড এজ বায়ো কণ্ট্ৰল। Baculovirus is used as a narrow spectrum herbicide. Herbicide, I think we understand, right? Herbicides, weedicides, pesticides, right? Herbicides মানে কি, কিছুমান herbs মাৰিবৰ কাৰণে যিবিলাক chemicals use কৰা হয় তাক আমি কি বুলি কওঁ, herbicides বুলি কওঁ, right? Next, we have a term called as narrow spectrum. Narrow spectrum আৰু broad spectrum herbicides, but narrow spectrum pesticide, broad spectrum pesticide. We have to understand the meaning অফ নেৰো স্পেক্ট্ৰাম আৰু ব্ৰড স্পেক্ট্ৰাম। ব্ৰড স্পেক্ট্ৰাম মানে সি বহুতবিলাক, তাৰ কেপাচিটিটো বেছি, এণ্ড হি হেজ এ পাৱাৰ টু এটেক মেনি প্লেণ্টছ এট ওৱান গ'। কিন্তু নেৰো স্পেক্ট্ৰামৰ কি হয় যে স্পেচিফিকলি উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট হষ্ট স্পেচিফিক। এটা ক্ৰপ ফিল্ডত ছাপ'জ বহুতবিলাক ভেৰাইটিজ অফ ক্ৰপছ আৰ গ্ৰ'য়িং, এণ্ড টুগেডাৰ উইথ দেট ক্ৰপছ ইউ হেভ ছিড, চাৰ্টেন টাইপছ অফ উইডছ অলছ' গ্ৰ'য়িং ইন দেট ছেম এৰিয়া। নাও ৱাট ইউ ৱান্ট ইজ, ইউ অবভিয়াছলি ৱান্ট দ্য ক্ৰপছ এণ্ড অৰ দ্য ইউ ৱান্ট দ্য ক্ৰপ প্লেণ্টছ এণ্ড নট দ্য উইডছ। সেইকাৰণে উইডছবিলাক গুচাব লাগিলে তুমি কিছুমান কেমিকেলছ দিব লাগিব, আৰু কেমিকেলছবিলাক দিয়াৰ সময়ত এইটো উই হেভ টু পে ইণ্টাৰেষ্ট চ' ডেট দিছ কেমিকেলছ ডাজ নট এফেক্ট দ্য ইকনমিকেলি ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট প্লাণ্টছ। চ' এনেকুৱা কিছুমান কেমিকেলছ দিম যোনে নেকি অকল উইডছখিনিহে মাৰে, তাৰ লগতে গুজি থকা বেলেগ প্লেণ্টছবিলাকক নামাৰে। চ' তেনেকৈ যদি সৰু বস্তু এটাক আমি টাৰ্গেট কৰি লওঁ, ডেট ইজ হোৱাট ইজ কল্ড এজ নেৰো স্পেক্ট্ৰাম হাৰ্বিচাইড। তাৰমানে অকল কিছুমান স্পেচিফিক প্লেণ্টছহে এই হার্বিসাইডটোৱে মাৰিব, গোটেই প্লেণ্টছবিলাকক জেনেৰেলি নামাৰে, ৰাইট? ইট ইজ ইউজ ইন ইণ্টিগ্ৰেটেড পেষ্ট মেনেজমেণ্ট। চ' এই পইণ্টটো মনত ৰাখিব লাগিব যে বেকিউলো ভাইৰাছ কিহৰ কাৰণে ইউজ হয়, ইণ্টিগ্ৰেটেড পেষ্ট মেনেজমেণ্ট। ইণ্টিগ্ৰেটেড পেষ্ট মেনেজমেণ্ট ইজ এ প্ৰগ্ৰাম, ৰাইট? চ' য'ত নেকি লাৰ্জ লাৰ্জ এৰিয়াজবিলাকত আমি পেষ্টবিলাক কণ্ট্ৰল কৰোঁ, কেনেকৈ কণ্ট্ৰল কৰোঁ, উইথ দ্য হেল্প অফ এপ্লাইং আ বায়'লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজম। এণ্ড ৱাট ইজ দ্য অৰ্গেনিজম উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট? উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট দিছ ভাইৰাছ, ৰাইট? It is also used in biologically sensitive area. Biologically sensitive area মানে, as I have given the previous example, এখন crop field আছে, crop field খনত crop plants বিলাক আছে, যোনবিলাক নেকি very important from economical point of view, তাৰ লগতে কিছুমান weedsও আছে. So you have to kill the weeds and not the crop plants. তেনেকে host specific, এটা সৰু বা এটা small amount of plants only you need to kill. So in those cases, what we use is baculo virus. So as far as biocontrol agents or microbes or biocontrol or key role, these are the examples that we need to remember. Tar bhitor maximum questions has come about BT or Bacillus thuringiensis, and specially example is called as BT cotton. What I said, the BT is a gene. এই জিনডাল আমি কি কৰিব পাৰোঁ, বেলেগ বেলেগ প্লেণ্টছৰ ভিতৰত ইনকৰ্পৰেট কৰিব পাৰোঁ, আৰু ইনকৰ্পৰেট যদি সেইডাল প্লেণ্টৰ ভিতৰত বিটি জিনটো থাকে, তেতিয়াহ'লে সেই প্লেণ্টডালক স্পেচিফিক কিছুমান ইনচেক্টছে এটেক কৰিব নোৱাৰে। ফৰ এক্সাম্পল, উই হেভ এ কটন প্লেণ্ট, কটন প্লেণ্টত কি কৰিছোঁ আমি, বিটি জিনটো ইনজেক্ট কৰি দিছোঁ। তাৰপিছত দিছ কটন প্লেণ্ট বিকামছ ৰেজিষ্টেণ্ট টু আ পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ টাইপ অফ আ ৱৰ্ম কল্ড এজ বল ৱৰ্ম, BALLWORM। চ' বিটি কটন প্লেণ্টডালক কেতিয়াও বল ৱৰ্ম নামৰ ইনচেক্টটোৱে এটেক কৰিব নোৱাৰে। কিয় নোৱাৰে? কাৰণ এই জিনটো সেই কটনডালৰ ভিতৰত আছে। চ' ইন দেট ৱে ৱাট উই হেভ ডান ইজ উই হেভ ট্ৰাইড টু কণ্ট্ৰল ওৱান টাইপ অফ আ মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজম, ওৱান টাইপ অফ আ বায়'লজিকেল অৰ্গেনিজম। নেক্সট ইজ, এইটো পইণ্ট ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট, ছেকেণ্ড পইণ্ট কি, সাইক্লোস্পোরিন এ। এই পইণ্টটো ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট, ক'ৰ পৰা ডিৰাইভ হৈছে, আৰু ইমিউনো চাপ্ৰেছিং। এইখিনি পাৰ্টৰ পৰা জেনেৰেলি ইণ্টিগ্ৰেটেড পেষ্ট মেনেজমেণ্টৰ পৰা অকণমান কুৱেশ্যন আহিছে। চ' এইখিনি আমি চাম। Next we go to microbes as biofertilizers, right? So generally whenever we talk about biofertilizers, right, we are talking about fertilizers. Fertilizers ami kiho karne apply koru, so that the increase or so that the crop yield increases, right? So crops or yield to increase koribo lagile ami fertilizers use koru. Fertilizers could be chemical and it could be biological also. So chemical fertilizers obviously tat ki thakibo bahut bor negative ba harmful effects thakibo. So we are trying to decrease the use of chemical fertilizers and increase the use of biological fertilizers. Whenever we are talking about biological fertilizers, we have to remember the word called as organic farming, right? Ajikali to sobe organic farming or kotha koy na, organic vegetables se khabo lage. Like all people speak about this. Now what is organic farming? We will not go into details, but to have a very small or simple idea about organic farming, ami ki janu je eyat enuka dhoronor farming kisuman kore ba yate enuka dhoronor crops bilak grow kore aru hei crops bilakot ki kore kono dhoronor chemical substance tat add no kore, right? Pesticide hog ba fertilizers hog ebilak jiman pur use hoy no, karan crops eta তুমি গ্ৰ' কৰিবা, তেন অভিয়াছলি তাততো ফাৰ্টিলাইজাৰ্ছ লাগিবই, ৰাইট? আৰু প্লাছ তোমাক তাত ভেৰিয়াছ টাইপছ অফ ইনচেক্টছ উইল অলছ' ইনফেক্ট দেট প্লাণ্ট, ৰাইট? টু ষ্টপ দেট, সেই ইনচেক্টছবিলাকে যাতে ক্ৰপ ফিল্ডটো নষ্ট কৰি নিদিয়ে, আইডাৰ উই কেন গ' ফৰ স্প্ৰেয়িং চাম কেমিকেলছ অৰ উই কেন গ্ৰ' ফৰ চাম বায়'লজিকেল মিনছ। চ' অৰ্গেনিক ফাৰ্মিং কি, এনি টাইপ অফ আ ফাৰ্মিং দেট ইজ ডান বাই বায়'লজিকেল মিনছ ইজ কল্ড এজ অৰ্গেনিক ফাৰ্মিং। চ' বায়' ফাৰ্টিলাইজাৰ্ছ ক'ত ইউজ হয়, অৰ্গেনিক ফাৰ্মিং। নেক্সট, some examples of microorganisms that has been used as a biofertilizer. Biofertilizer bili koa loge loge, the first and the most common example that we remember is obviously about rhizobium, no? Rhizobium ki hoy, eta bacteria. Whenever we talk about rhizobium, rhizobium kot pai, it is found in, or it generally we have talked about association of rhizobium with the roots of leguminous plants. Jedi monot ase root nodule bili kiba ta bostu porhisila, if you remember, monot ase ne লেগিউমিনাছ প্লেণ্টছবিলাকৰ ৰুট নডিউলছ আছিলে ন, আৰু ৰুট নডিউলছবিলাকৰ ভিতৰত কিছুমান মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজমছ আছিলে, এণ্ড এজ আ ৰিজাল্ট হোৱাট হেপেন্স, দিছ টাইপ অফ প্লেণ্টছ উইল অলৱেজ ইনক্ৰিজ দ্য ফাৰ্টিলিটি অফ দ্য ছইল, ৰাইট? চ' ফাৰ্টিলিটি ইনক্ৰিজ কৰিছে। চ' ওৱান অফ দ্য মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজম দেট উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট ইজ ৰাইজোবিয়াম। ৱাট ইজ ৰাইজোবিয়াম? ইট ইজ নাথিং বাট এ নাইট্ৰ'জেন ফিক্সাৰ, ন? লেগিউমিনাছ প্লেণ্টছৰ আমি সেই নাইট্ৰ'জেন ফিক্সেশ্যন মিনাৰেল নিউট্ৰিশ্যন চেপ্টাৰ উই হেভ অলৰেডি ডান, right? What is important is nitrogen fixer is something that we all know. What is important is the nitrogen fixers bilake either tahate symbiotically thakibo kisuman gosor logot associate hoi pelai nohole tahate keneke thakibo the soilot nije nije thakibo. So we would be using two words, that is symbiotic relationship and free living condition, right? So nitrogen fixers two types hobo pare, either they are symbiotic or they are free living. So rhizobium is an example of symbiotically living nitrogen fixer. আৰু কাৰ লগত চিম্বায়'টিক ৰিলেশ্যনত থাকে, ৰুটছ অফ লেগিউমিনাছ প্লেণ্টছৰ লগত চিম্বায়'টিক ৰিলেশ্যন থাকে. নেক্সট উই কাম টু দ্য নেক্সট টাইপ অফ নাইট্ৰজেন ফিক্সাৰ, ফৰ এক্সাম্পল এজোটোবেক্টাৰ আৰু এজোস্পিৰুলাম, এই দুটাও কি হৈছে, দে আৰ অলছো নাইট্ৰজেন ফিক্সাৰ্ছ, ৰাইট? কিন্তু দে আৰ এক্সাম্পলছ অফ ফ্ৰী লিভিং নাইট্ৰজেন ফিক্সাৰ্ছ. চ' এই বস্তুটো আমি উই হেভ টু পে ইণ্টাৰেষ্ট. Right? So question ahibo, suppose question to ahile, azotobacter is an example of a free living nitrogen fixer and a symbiotic nitrogen fixer, right? So we need to remember that they are examples of free living nitrogen fixer that stay in the soil. Next is, obviously we have talked about mycorrhiza when we have talked about biological classification, no? Tate ki asile mycorrhiza point to asile. Mycorrhiza, we know, what is mycorrhiza? It is a symbiotic association between whom and whom? মাইকৰহাইজা কি হয়, এটা এছ'চিয়েশ্যন ন, দুটা বস্তুৰ মাজত এছ'চিয়েশ্যনটোক আমি মাইকৰহাইজা কওঁ. কি কি বস্তু আছিলে, যেনেকৈ ৰাইজ'বিয়াম ক'ত থাকে, চিম্বায়'টিকেলি থাকে ইন দ্য ৰুটছ অফ লেগিউমিনাছ প্লেণ্টছ. চ' মাইকৰহাইজাল এছ'চিয়েশ্যন বা আৰু ধৰা এছ'চিয়েশ্যন কৰা, ফৰ এক্সাম্পল ইফ ইউ টক এবাউট লাইকেন, লাইকেন ইজ অলছ' এন এছ'চিয়েশ্যন. চ' ৱেন এভাৰ উই টক এবাউট এছ'চিয়েশ্যন, উই হেভ টু ন' এবাউট দ্য বোথ পাৰ্টনাৰ্ছ, ৰাইট? চ' মাইকৰহাইজাল এছ'চিয়েশ্যন মানে কি? Can anyone give me the answer? Mycorrhizal association, or what is the meaning? It is the association between? Monot asane? Mycorrhizal association, it is nothing but fungi staying with the roots of higher plants, right? Rhizobium with leguminous plant, hetueta association, symbiotic association. Next is fungi with the roots of higher plants, that is called as mycorrhizal association. If you are talking about lichens, algae and fungi staying together, that is called as lichens, right? So we are talking about mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza, what we need to know is there is a specific genus of mycorrhiza that is called as glomus. Our glomus e ki kore, mycorrhizal association bilak kore. Now what we understand by mycorrhizal association, you have a plant, suppose that our plant, ঠিক আছে, প্লান্টৰ roots বিলাক আছে ন, mycorrhizal association কত হয়, roots হ'ব, right? So mycorrhiza to e ki koribo, a roots in and around তোমাৰ net ekhon form koribo, right? So they will stay in association. So this is what is called as mycorrhizal association. Kune form kore mycorrhiza? Mycorrhiza at a specific genus, we have to talk about glomas. Our mycorrhizal association of karne plant dalor ki help hoy, je it generally bahut bilak different different types of benefits it has, but the most important point that we have to talk about is it leads to phosphate absorption, right? So mycorrhizal association or karone plant dale soil or pra ki absorb koribo pare, phosphate absorb koribo pare. Jeneke rhizobium or symbiotic association ba rhizobium jodi nitrogenous fixation or kam kore, ta plant dale ki lobo, nitrogen lobo, right? Mycorrhizal association or karone plant dale generally ki lobo, they will take the phosphate of the soil. So a point to ami monot rakhim. Next we come to the last one, that is cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria, they are also called as ki blue green algae. They belong to which kingdom? They belong to Monera, if you remember, right? So examples of cyanobacteria, Anabina, Nostoc, Oscillataria, etc., these are examples of certain types of cyanobacteria. And cyanobacteria, obviously they always act as a very good biofertilizer, right? Especially if you are talking about increasing the fertility in the paddy fields, no? Tetahale we always talk about the role of cyanobacteria. Oscillataria helps in increasing the fertility of the paddy fields. Then we have another cyanobacteria, for example Olocera, right? Olocera yo ki kore paddy field or tar fertility to increase kore. So ultimately what we can conclude is cyanobacteria always plays a major role as a biofertilizer. So from this section, these are the only examples that you have to remember. So biocontrol agent or data example, or biofertilizer or data example. So apart from this, there are certain points that you need to remember from examination point of view. You have a product that is called as statins, ৰাইট? অলপ আগতে যেনেকে আমি সাইক্লোস্পৰিন এৰ কথা পঢ়িলোঁ ন, সাইক্লোস্পৰিন এ কি হয়, এটা প্ৰডাক্ট, ৰাইট? সেই প্ৰডাক্টটো ক'ৰ পৰা ডিৰাইভ কৰিছে, ট্ৰাইকোডাৰ্মাৰ পৰা ডিৰাইভ কৰিছে। চিমিলাৰলি কুৱেশ্যনছ আৰ আস্ক এবাউট ষ্টেটিনছ অলছো, ষ্টেটিনছ ক'ৰ পৰা ডিৰাইভ কৰিছে, মোনাস্কাছ পুৰপুৰিয়াৰ পৰা, চ' ইউ হেভ টু ৰিমেম্বাৰ দিছ, ৰাইট? ষ্টেটিনছ। নেক্সট ইজ ৱাট ইজ দ্য ৱৰ্ক অফ আ ষ্টেটিন, যেনেকে সাইক্লোস্পৰিন এৰ কাম কি আছিলে, ইমিউনো ছাপ্ৰেছিং এজেণ্ট, ঠিক আছে? ঠিক তেনেকে ষ্টেটিনৰ কাম কি, ইট লোৱাৰ্ছ দ্য ব্লাড কলেষ্ট্ৰল, ৰাইট? মানুহৰ যদি কলেষ্ট্ৰল লেভেল বেছি হৈ যায় তে অবভিয়াছলি উই হেভ টু টেক মেডিচিনছ ফ্ৰম আউটছাইড, এণ্ড ওৱান টাইপ অফ মেডিচিন ইজ অলৱেজ ষ্টেটিন। চ' ৱাট ইজ দ্য কুৱেশ্যন দেট ইজ আস্কড ইজ, চ' কুৱেশ্যন আহিব পাৰে সাইক্লোস্পৰিন এৰ কাম কি, যে ইট কি কৰিব, ইমিউনো ছাপ্ৰেছিং এজেণ্ট ন, ঠিক তেনেকে ষ্টেটিনছে কাম কি কৰিব, ব্লাড কলেষ্ট্ৰল লেভেল লোৱাৰ কৰিব। আৰু লাষ্ট ক্লাছত আমি কি পঢ়িছিলোঁ, উই হেভ টক এবাউট ষ্ট্ৰেপ্টোকাইনেজ অলছো ন, ইফ ইউ ৰিমেম্বাৰ উই হেভ টক এবাউট দিছ চলিউশ্যন অফ ব্লাড ক্লট, ব্লাড ক্লটবিলাক ৰিমুভ কৰিব লাগিলে কোনে ৰিমুভ কৰিব, ষ্ট্ৰেপ্টোকাইনেজে ৰিমুভ কৰিব। চ' এই তিনিটা পইণ্ট ভেৰি ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট, ষ্ট্ৰেপ্টোকাইনেজ, দিছ চলিউশ্যন অফ ব্লাড ক্লট, ইফ ইউ আৰ টকিং এবাউট সাইক্লোস্পৰিন এ, ইমিউনো ছাপ্ৰেছিং এজেণ্ট, ইফ ইউ আৰ টকিং এবাউট ষ্টেটিনছ, it helps in lowering the blood cholesterol. এই তিনিটাৰ পৰা question বহুত আহে। Next is, we have to know something that is called as টোডি, right? What is টোডি? টোডি is nothing but an alcoholic type of a drink, right? So টোডি is a drink. এই ড্ৰিংকটো ক'ৰ পৰা বনায়, it is made from the sap of the palm tree. Palm tree জানো ন, খেজুৰ গছবিলাক, সেই খেজুৰ গছৰ sapটো, what we understand by sap now, the inside content, right? That is what is called as sap. Generally, if you are talking about phloem, no? Phloem thakibo, xylem phloem, we understand. Phloem or bitor junkin contents of the takami ki bili kom, phloem sap, no? He sapor para eta drink bonai, ar he drink to nam ki hoi toddy, and this is the drink that is very much commonly used in South India. Right? So, toddy ko para ulai, that you need to know. Next is, chloromycetin, এৰিথ্ৰমাইচিন, পেনিচিলিন আৰু ষ্টেপ্টোমাইচিন, এইকেইটাৰ পৰাও কুৱেশ্যন আহে যে কোন অৰ্গেনিজিমৰ পৰা প্ৰডিউচ কৰে। ফৰ এক্সাম্পল, পেনিচিলিন ইজ অবটেইন ফ্ৰম পেনিচিলিয়াম ক্ৰাইচ'জিৰাম। চ' এইকেইটা মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজিমছ আমি মনত ৰাখিব লাগিব। চিমিলাৰলি ক্ৰ'মাইচিটিন ইজ অবটেইন ফ্ৰম ষ্ট্ৰেপ্টোমাইচিছ ভেনিজুৱেলি, ৰাইট? ঠিক তেনেকে ষ্ট্ৰেপ্টোমাইচিন ইজ অবটেইন ফ্ৰম ষ্ট্ৰেপ্টোমাইচিছ গ্ৰেচিয়াছ। চ' এইকেইটা মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজিমছ ফ্ৰম এক্সামিনেশ্যন পইণ্ট অফ ভিউ উই নীড টু ৰিমেম্বাৰ। So up till here, what we have done is, we have almost completed the role of microorganisms. The last part that we are left is sea waste treatment. So we will be going to, so we will be discussing sea waste treatment. Yaloke kiba doubts asil nike? What is important from examination point of view, I have already mentioned. So please read those lines properly, right? So asam kiba doubts asil nike? Okay, so if everything is understood, then we can move to the next topic. Just a second, let me clean the board. So, do you have any type of doubts or questions from this portion? Jiti etia lake buji paisa, what is your work to be done is, please follow or please go through the MCQ books, right? So, MCQ books bilak follow koriba, etu chapter saba, and just see what other types of questions that have been asked, right? Apparently, you put into the habit of practicing the MCQs, all the chapters would become clear, right? Thank you. we'll be talking about one very important part of this lesson. It is sewage treatment. Right? So whenever we talk about sewage, sewage is something that consists of a lot number of polluted substance in it, right? Bohut letra letra bostu ekelage thake, and that is what is called as sewage. This sewage cannot be disposed directly into the water bodies, no? Junblak sewage ami pao, sewage ami ko pra pao, right? From factories, from drains, etc., etc., right? So, a sewage, a letra pani kini, ami directly ki koribo nwaru, water bodies are disposed koribo nwaru. And what is the reason behind? If suppose we dispose the sewage without treatment, that would be a major cause for causing pollution. So we should not be doing that. So we need to treat the sewage. First we need to know the sewage to them treat koribo lage kiho karne, what is the content of the sewage. So whenever we talk about sewage, what we know is it needs to be treated or cleaned before disposing, right? Second, cleaning ami kihere koru? Cleaning of sewage is done by heterotrophic microorganisms. It's a heterotrophic is a word that you need to remember. I think we know, no? Autotrophs are heterotrophs. Those who can prepare their own food, that is called as autotrophs. Arjune nizok phabustu banabo noare, that is called as heterotroph. So heterotrophic microorganisms will like help loi bilai. Ami ki koru? Sewage to ami treat koru or clean koru. Kyo clean koru? Karon it would be a cause of pollution if it is not treated. Now, sewage generally contains It contains human, comma, animal excreta, right? It contains a lot of organic matter and it also contains pathogens, right? And so they are very harmful. আৰু ইমানখিনি লেতেৰা বস্তু থকা পানীখিনি যদি আমি পানীত বা ৱাটাৰ বডিজত ডিছপ'জ কৰি দিওঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে অভিয়াছলি কি হ'ব পলিউশ্যন হ'ব ন চ' ডেট পলিউশ্যন ইন অৰ্ডাৰ টু চেক দ্যাট অৰ ইন অৰ্ডাৰ টু প্ৰিভেণ্ট দ্য পলিউশ্যন ৱাট উই নীড টু ডু ইজ উই হেভ টু ট্ৰিট দ্য সিৱেজ দিছ ইজ ৱাট ইজ কল্ড এজ সিৱেজ ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট ইয়াৰ ভিতৰত আমি কি মনত ৰাখিব লাগিব দ্য ৱৰ্ড হেটৰট্ৰপিক মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজমছ ইয়াৰ ওপৰত কুৱেশ্যন আহে যে সিৱেজ ট্ৰিটমেণ্টৰ কাৰণে কেনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজমছবিলাক আমি ইউজ কৰোঁ উই ইউজ হেটৰট্ৰপিক microorganism. Now, how do you go for the treatment? I mean, treatment to keneke koru? This is what we are going to study now. Okay. So, whenever we talk about sewage treatment, no? The treatment process is followed in two steps. What are the two steps? First is called as the physical treatment, or we can say primary treatment. It is also there is something that is done physically. Physical treatment to ami kobo koru. And second, we have the secondary treatment. This secondary treatment is also called as biological treatment. राइट सो सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट आमि केनेके करू दुटा स्टेपर करू एटा होल प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट आरो एटा होल सेकेंडरी ट्रीटमेंट आफ्टर कम्प्लीशन अफ दीज टू स्टेप्स ओनली द सीवेज वाटर और द लेफ्ट ओवर वाटर वुड बी रेडी टू बी डिस्पोज्ड नाउ वी हैव टू नो द स्टेप्स अफ द प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट एंड द स्टेप्स अफ द सेकेंडरी ट्रीटमेंट बिफोर गोइंग सेकेंडरी ट्रीटमेंट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज बायोलॉजिकल ट्रीटमेंट सो एट दिस स्टेज और दिस इज द स्टेज वेयर द रोल ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स कम्स इन टू अकाउंट सो विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द प्राइमरी ट्रीटमेंट राइट केनेके होय बस्तुटो विल टॉक अबाउट इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ फ्लो चार्ट इनस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग सेंटेंसेस लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ फ्लो चार्ट सो वॉट वी हैव इज वी हैव द सीवेज राइट सीवेज इज डर्टी वी नो सीवेज गोज फॉर primary treatment. So what you do in the primary treatment? First, So we are talking about the first treatment, that is primary treatment. What is the first step of primary treatment? What we do is we try to remove the solid substances that are present in that sewage with the help of a net. For example, if you are talking about suppose this is a container that consists of the sewage. What we will do is ami ekon net lom no net khonor through ami ki korim we'll take out all this solid substance. Solid bilak ami ki koru with the help of a net we try to remove it. This is done physically and so primary treatment is also called as physical treatment. Etia ami kunu dhoroner microorganisms etia loke help kora nai. Ami ki korisu net ekhon loisu. Net khonore jiman bur solid substance asile tar pra jiman kini paru we just try to remove. After this step right? After doing this, what happens is it is filtered, right? So ki korilu I mean the solid substance bur jiman kini paru netere gusalu tar pisot we send that sewage for filtration. Filtration ot ki thakibo filter paper thakibo ar filter paper re ki koribo aru baki jikini solid substance asile hekini solid substance tahande remove koribo. After filtration what we go is we go for this third step that is called as sedimentation. So sewage kini first what we do we try to remove the debrises or the solid debrises with the help of a net then it is sent for filtration after filtration the amount or that liquid that is left is sent into a sedimentation tank and this process is called as sedimentation sedimentation tank ot ki hobo je jetia ami liquid to sediment korimo jekhini amar remaining asile etu step or pra tar pisot jekhini liquid asile jetia ami sediment korim tetia hale what we know by the process of sedimentation we see that the heavier substances always settle at the bottom right Let me draw the diagram. Right? So when we put the liquid into sedimentation tank, this is something that happens as we keep that liquid for sedimentation. As time passes by, what happens is the solid substance always settles down, and the liquid is something that floats at the top. So what we have. Ekdom tolot sedimentation tank or ekdom tolot we have that solid substance and that substance is called as primary sludge so you have to remember the word sludge sludge ki bostu junkini solid bostu settle hoi gol tak ami ki boli koisu sludge above this solid sludge we have some soil and pebble and the word that we are using is called as grit and above the grit we have the liquid and this liquid is called as primary ইফ্লুয়েণ্ট, ৰাইট? সো সেডিমেণ্টেশ্যনৰ কাৰণে আমি এনেকুৱা এটা কণ্ডিশ্যন পালোঁ আৰু তাৰপিছত আমি কি কৰিম যে এজ ফাৰ এজ দিছ প্ৰাইমেৰী স্লাজ ইজ কনচাৰ্ণ, অবভিয়াছলি এইখিনি চলিড, এইখিনি চলিড, সো উইল ট্ৰাই টু ৰিমুভ দ্য চলিড, ৰাইট? সো প্ৰাইমেৰী চলিড স্লাজ ইজ আনৱান্টেড. Unwanted for what? Unwanted for the treatment. আমি কি কৰি আছো? We are trying to clean up that sewage, right? While cleaning that sewage, these are the steps that we have followed, and ultimately in this first or primary treatment, we remove all types of solids, or we try to remove almost all types of solids that is present. How do you remove? First, with the help of a net, second, with the help of the filter paper, and third, because of the process called as sedimentation. So, ekhini loke ami ki boli kom primary treatment. In spite of this treatment, even now, we cannot say that the sewage is clean. Etiao, this liquid is not ready to be thrown off. So, this liquid needs to go for further treatment. And what is the step we are talking about? We are talking about the secondary treatment. So, second, primary treatment ekhini loke hogol. Tarpisot, will go for secondary treatment. Secondary treatment is also called as the biological treatment. So secondary treatment dot kunkhini ahibo? Secondary treatment, right? And who undergoes secondary treatment? It is the primary effluent. এই নামবিলাক আমি মনত ৰাখিব লাগিব। প্ৰাইমেৰি ইফ্লুয়েণ্ট কি আছিলে? উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট দ্য লিকুইড ফ্ৰম দ্য চেডিমেণ্টেশ্যন টেংক, ৰাইট? এইখিনিতো আমি পেলাই দিলোঁ ন, প্ৰাইমেৰী স্লাজো পেলাই দিলোঁ, গ্ৰীটো পেলাই দিলোঁ, থাকিল কি প্ৰাইমেৰী ইফ্লুয়েণ্ট অ' দ্য লিকুইড। এইখিনিক আমি কি কৰিম? ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টলৈ পঠাই দিম। চ' দিছ ইজ পুট আণ্ডাৰ ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট। চ' ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টত একচুৱেলি হয় কি? ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টত কি কৰে যে প্ৰাইমেৰী effluent jikhini asile it is sent into aeration tank. Eta tank ole pathai dia aru he tank tu ami ki boli koisu aeration tank. What does a tank look like? It is something like this. Aru ei tank tu kisuman fenor isma bostu thakibo. So whenever you are talking about or learning or you are studying about sewage treatment, what I would suggest is instead of going through the notes directly or line ki line porhatke, it is always advisable to go through the diagrams and then have an idea, and after that you can go through the notes, right? So what we have done is we have taken the primary effluent kopra loisu primary treatment opra. Hey effluent kine ami kot pathaisu aeration tank ole pathaisu. This is what is called as the aeration tank. This tank ki thakibo? এইখিনি কি হয়? প্ৰাইমেৰী ইফ্লুয়েণ্ট, ৰাইট? এই টেংকটোত কি হ'ব যে আমি বাহিৰৰ পৰা এটা এয়াৰ পাম্প দিম, আৰু এয়াৰ পাম্পৰ থ্ৰুৰে উই উইল চেণ্ট ইন এয়াৰ ইন টু দ্য চেম্বাৰ। এইটো কি হয়? এয়াৰ পাম্প। এইটো কি হয়? এজিটেটৰ্ছ। সো প্ৰাইমেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টৰ পৰা আমি যিটো লিকুইড পাইছিলোঁ সেই লিকুইডটো আমি ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টলৈ পঠাম। ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টৰ ফাৰ্ষ্ট ষ্টেপ কি হৈছে যে ইট হেজ টু বি চেণ্ট টু দ্য এৰিয়েশ্যন টেংক। ৱাট ইজ দ্য এৰিয়েশ্যন টেংক? ইট ইজ সামথিং লাইক দিছ ৱেৰ উই হেভ আ এয়াৰ পাম্প, আৰু এয়াৰ পাম্পৰ থ্ৰুৰে আমি কি কৰিছোঁ? উই আৰ পাম্পিং ইন এয়াৰ ফ্ৰম আউটছাইড টু দেট লিকুইড। চ' এই লিকুইডটোলৈ আমি বাহিৰৰ পৰা কি কৰিছোঁ? এয়াৰ পাম্পিং কৰিছোঁ। এণ্ড দিছ চেম্বাৰ অলছো হেজ চাম এজিটেটৰ্ছ। ৱাট ইজ দ্য এজিটেটৰ? ব্লেডৰ নিচিনা বা ফেনৰ নিচিনা, দেট ইজ ৱাট ইজ called as a agitator. Ta mane ei khon ki kore je it keeps on moving anake round round he move kori thakibo. He jete move kori thakibo tela pani khini move hoy thakibo na, will have almost like something called as a whirling effect, right? So ghuri ghuri thakibo, that is what is the work of the agitators, right? So jete air diso plus you have the agitators, because of this two action what happens in the aeration tank is yate thaka asolte ei liquid tut ki asile organic matters bilak asile no, hey organic matters bilak asile plus kisuman pathogens asile. So because of this two region the pumping in of air and the role of acidators, the number of aerobic bacteria in that liquid increases. So a step to karone, what happens is number of aerobic bacteria increases, right? So aerobic bacteria jete increase hoy, so tahate ki koribo a liquid khinit ki asile organic substance asile organic substance ot etia ki dekhilu je number of aerobic bacteria increases. This aerobic bacteria kenuka dhoronor asile, these bacteria were nothing but heterotrophic bacteria. A bacteria bilak survive koribo lagile tahate food lobo laibo, jehetu they are not autotrophs, so they have to take in the food, right? So food hisabe kun khini loise, the organic matter that is present in this liquid act as a food for this organism. So jti number of bacteria increase korile tetia hole yate thaka organic substance bilak komi jabone na jai, karon organic substance bilak bacteria hisabe ki hisabe use korisile food hisabe. So these are the bacteria that were having the organic matter as food. So as the number of bacteria will increase, the number of organic the amount of organic substance in this effluent will keep on decreasing. So ki hol number of aerobic bacteria increase. Next is amount of organic matter decreases. And we have to talk about something called as BOD. BOD ki hoy? Biochemical oxygen demand. BOD also decreases. So question to kene ke ahe, je jetia primary treatment hoi jai, the liquid is sent to the secondary treatment. So what happens in the secondary treatment? The first step of the secondary treatment is something, or we have to talk about the role of aeration tank. In the aeration tank, what we have done is we have supplied air from outside, and plus they already have the acidators. As a result of this two action, these are the things that happen. Ki ki hoise? Aerobic bacteria bahi goise. Jete aerobic bacteria bahi goise, tetia hole ki goise? They have eaten, or they have tried, or they have started to eat the organic matter that was present in the liquid. As a result, amount of organic matter decreased and BOD also decreased. Now what is BOD? BOD is nothing but biological oxygen demand or biochemical oxygen demand, right? Biological oxygen demand tar mane biological oxygen demand or biochemical oxygen demand or BOD is a type of measurement. Ar a measurement to ami ki maba is a type of a study. Ar a study to ki ho karne koru, just to see the amount of organic matter that is present in a liquid, right? Eta water body polluted hoy ne no hoy, right? Hey bostu tu jodi ami janibo lage, we study something called as BOD. What does BOD indicate? BOD indicates the amount of organic matter that is present in that water body. Ar jodi organic matter beshi thake tete hale obviously that water is polluted. In vice versa, what we can say is jodi organic matter kom thake tete hale the water is less polluted. Is the point understood? So yate ki hoise je prothomote jehetu ami primary effluent asile, effluent tu ki asile obviously polluted asile. A polluted ba polluted water or uporot kune kam korile, aerobic bacteria played a role, and as a result, because of these things, BOD also decreased, right? So ultimately organic matter or BOD. So question tu iar pra ki ahe, ekhini point tu ahiboi tar upori eta question ahe, BOD tur importance ki, the study of BOD is important, or what does BOD indicate? We'll be discussing certain type of questions and then we'll be clear. As of now, BOD means what? Oxygen demand. Who demands the oxygen? It is always the bacteria that it demands the oxygen. Bacteria oxygen ki ho karne lage to survive. If it has to survive, then it has to take in the food. Which food we are talking about? We are talking about organic matter. So organic matter jodi beshi thake tete hale BOD beshi lagibo. Organic matter jodi kom thake tete hale BOD level kom hobo, right? So that is what is the relation between organic matter and BOD. So if organic matter decreases, BOD also decreases. A point to ami mone rakhibo laibo, right? So ultimately from this treatment, ইয়াতে কি দেখিলো যে নাম্বার অফ অর্গানিক বেক্টেরিয়া ইনক্রিজেস নাও দিজ এরোবিক বেক্টেরিয়া ন এই যোনবিলাক মাইক্রো অর্গানিজমস বিলাকৰ কথা কৈ আছো এই মাইক্রো অর্গানিজমস বিলাক ইয়াতে বেছি হৈ যাব এন্ড দিস মাইক্রো অর্গানিজমস রিমেইন ইন দ্য ট্যাঙ্ক এজ আ ম্যাশ হোৱাট ইজ আ ম্যাশ নেট লাইক সাবস্টেন্স ন প্রথমতে পানি আছিলে পানির দ্বারা তোমার বেক্টেরিয়াব বাড়ি গল আর বেক্টেরিয়াব বাড়ি বাড়ি কি হল যে ম্যাশর নিচনা ইট ইজ কল্ড এজ ম্যাশ সো দে রিমেইন এজ আ ম্যাশ অ্যান্ড দে আর কল্ড এজ এইখিনিলৈকে আমি বুজি পাইছোঁনে নাই চ' ইয়াতে আমি কি কৈ আছোঁ যে প্ৰাইমেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট হৈ গ'ল তাৰপিছত আমি ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট কৰিব লাগিব কিহৰ কাৰণে ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট কৰিব লাগিব কাৰণ প্ৰাইমেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টৰ কাৰণে দ্য ৱাটাৰ ৱাজ নট চ' ভেৰি ক্লিন ৰাইট চ' ইট হেড টু আণ্ডাৰগ' দ্য ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টত আমি কি ইউজ কৰিছোঁ প্ৰাইমেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট অৰ দ্য লিকুইড উই হেভ ইউজ ৰাইট ইট হেজ চেণ্ট টু দ্য এৰিয়েশ্যন টেংক এৰিয়েশ্যন টেংকত কি হ'ল দ্য নাম্বাৰ অফ এৰোবিক বেক্টেৰিয়া ইনক্ৰিজড আৰু এই এৰোবিক বেক্টেৰিয়াবিলাক দে অলৱেজ ৰিমেইন ইন দ্য ফৰ্ম অফ আ নেট এণ্ড দেট ইজ ৱাট ইজ কল্ড এজ মেশ আৰু এই যিবিলাক বেক্টেৰিয়া বাঢ়ি গ'ল অকল যে বেক্টেৰিয়া থাকিব নট নেচেচেৰী বেলেগ ধৰণৰ মাইক্ৰ' অৰ্গেনিজমছো থাকিব পাৰে এই গোটেইখিনি অৰ্গেনিজমছ আমি কি বুলি কৈছোঁ ফ্লক নাও ইউ হেভ টু ৰিমেম্বাৰ দ্য ৱৰ্ড ফ্লক অলপ আগতে এটা ৱৰ্ড পাইছিলোঁ ডেট ৱাজ কল্ড এজ স্লাজ ৰাইট চ' টকিং এবাউট দ্য সিৱেজ ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট চাম পইণ্টছ আৰ ভেৰি ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট ৱাট ইজ প্ৰাইমেৰী স্লাজ ৱাট ইজ আ ফ্লক ৰাইট নেক্সট ইজ ৱাট ইজ বি অ' ডি নেক্সট উইল বি ডিছকাছিং চামথিং কল্ড এজ এক্টিভেটেড স্লাজ চ' টাৰ্মছবিলাক মনত ৰাখিবা চ' আপ টিল নাও ৱাট ইউ হেভ চিন ইজ উই হেভ গট চামথিং কল্ড এজ ফ্লক্স নেক্সট ইজ দ্য ফ্লক্স need to be treated. So this flocks that we have got in the aeration tank will be treated. Quote by Sue, in the aeration tank, right? A flocks can you ulai pilai, they are sent to a sedimentation tank. So sedimentation process to kebar hol dubar hol first time primary treatment ot hoisile aru etia ako secondary treatment ot again we are following the concept or we are following the process of sedimentation. This time who undergoes sedimentation? It is the flock that undergoes sedimentation. And once we are talking about sedimentation, this is again something that happens. Etia ki hobo ইয়াতে আকৌ সলিড সাবস্টেন্সবিলাক সেটল ডাউন কৰিব ৰাইট আৰু লিকুইডটো ওপৰত থাকিব ৰাইট দিছ লিকুইড ইজ কল্ড এজ ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট এণ্ড দিছ ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট ইজ ডিছপ'জড অ'কে এট দিছ পইণ্ট ৱাট ইউ নীড টু ন' আমি দুটা ৱৰ্ড পালোঁ প্ৰাইমেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট আৰু ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট প্ৰাইমেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট ক'ত আছিলে প্ৰাইমেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টত ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট ক'ত আছে ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্টত ডিউৰিং প্ৰাইমেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট আমি কি ট্ৰিট কৰিছিলোঁ ইফ্লুৱেণ্টখিনি ট্ৰিট কৰিছিলোঁ ছলিডখিনি পেলাই দিছিলোঁ বাট ইন কেছ অফ ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ট্ৰিটমেণ্ট দিছ টাইম ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট উড বি ডিছপ'জড আৰু আমি কাক চাফা কৰিম উইল বি ক্লিনিং আপ দিছ dry or this solid substance not dry obviously solid substance this solid substance is called as চ' ছেডিমেণ্টেশ্যন টেংক আছে লিকুইড আৰু ছলিড পাইছোঁ লিকুইডখিনি কি বুলি কৈছোঁ ছেকেণ্ডেৰী ইফ্লুৱেণ্ট বুলি কৈছোঁ আৰু ছলিডখিনি কি বুলি কৈছোঁ ছেডিমেণ্টেৰী স্লাজ বাট দ্য প্ৰপাৰ টাৰ্ম অফ ছেডিমেণ্টেৰী স্লাজ ইজ এক্টিভেটেড স্লাজ A point to him are important from examination point of view. Sedimentary sludge is not a word that we use. Instead, we use a word called as activated sludge. So, pothomote first treatment of ami ki paisilo, primary sludge paisilo. Secondary treatment of ami ki palo, we got something called as activated sludge. Now, this activated sludge would undergo further treatment. What will happen to the activated sludge? Etial, okay, it's not ready to be disposed. So, we have to treat it further. So, this time what we would be treating is we will be working upon the activated sludge. Our activated sludge khini ki asile je junkini solid bustu ami paisilo sedimentation tank on. This activated sludge is divided into two parts. So, ami sludge kini ulai ani pelai, it is divided into two parts. Some of it, dota partar bhag kore, eta partok ami ki koru, some of it is sent back to the aeration tank. It acts as an inoculum for the growth of aerobic bacteria. Right? So, ki korilu? The activated sludge has been divided into two parts. One part is sent to the aeration tank. So, aeration tank kutu asile, junto tank asile, jo tank out, we have pumped air from outside. That is what is called as aeration tank. And in that aeration tank, which microorganism plays a major role? It is always the aerobic bacteria that plays a major role. And what is the role we are talking about? That aerobic bacteria eats up the organic matter that was present in that liquid, right? So, hey, organic matter kini remove koribo lagile, amak ki lagibo? Amak aerobic bacteria. Right, so aerobic bacteria growth to jate aeration tank or besi hoy. He karne ami ki koru activated sludge akoman ami inoculum hisabe tar pothai dio. Inoculum ki asile, I think we remember we have talked something called as inoculum or starter when we have talked about cart formation. Doi monowa homoy ami inoculum or kotha goiso. So some part of the activated sludge goes as an inoculum to the aeration tank. Rest. Due to second part of sludge, they are sent to an aerobic sludge digester. Right? So, activated sludge khinit ki asile aerobic bacteria bilak asile, right? Hey, aerobic bacteria ba aerobic microorganisms bilakok etia tahatoku ami destroy koribo leibo. Aerobic bacteria destroy koribo lagile ami tahatok eta tank ole pothabo leibo, and that tank contains of ki anaerobic bacteria, right? Anaerobic microorganisms bilake ki koribo aerobic bacteria bilakok mari pelabo, and that is what is called as anaerobic sludge digester. So, what happens in a digester or anaerobic sludge digester? Anaerobic organisms, anaerobic bacteria like Clostridium, Escherichia, E. coli, junto ami kono, anaerobic organisms like Clostridium, Escherichia are present, which attacks on the aerobic bacteria, and after this jete anaerobic bacteria bilake aerobic bacteria bilako mari pelabo, so what is left out with the liquid? It is microorganisms free. Ar jetia microorganism na thakibo, then obviously that would be the clean water, and now it is ready to be disposed. So what happens next is, now the liquid is ready to get disposed. and ultimately we have fulfilled our project. So what was our project is we had to clean that sewage, right? Hey, sewage kini ami safa koribo leibo, and after that only we had to dispose that sewage. So while going for cleaning, we have used or we have taken the help of certain types of microorganisms. What type of microorganisms? They are always heterotrophic microorganism. Microorganisms bilak ami kuntu treatment or use korisilo, they are always used in the second treatment and not in the first treatment, right? So ami keneke safa korilo, duta treatment korilo, primary or secondary. Primary treatment that we did is physically we have tried to remove all the solid substance that are present in that liquid, right? So we have gone for some process such as cleaning it with the help of a net. We have gone for filtration and then we have gone for sedimentation. After sedimentation or sedimentation brings an end to the primary treatment, sedimentation on karone junkini liquid ami palu, that is what is called as primary effluent. Hey, primary effluent goes to the secondary treatment. Secondary treatment of chitya goise, the tank that the liquid goes into is called as aeration tank. Aeration tank or ki hoise that we have supplied air from outside, and as a result the number of aerobic bacteria kept on increasing. Once the aerobic bacteria kept on increasing, the organic matter kept on decreasing, and finally the BOD or biochemical oxygen demand also kept on decreasing. Our biochemical oxygen demand BOD aru water or relation to ki je jodi BOD to kom thake tete hala water to ki hobo je clean hobo, jodi BOD beshi thake tete hala water to polluted hobo, right? So BOD decrease korile, so jete BOD decrease korise we at least come to an conclusion that it is comparatively cleaner now. But in spite of that ami further treatment korilu. What is the second treatment? We got something called as flox. No flox ki asile je junbilak aerobic bacteria by aerobic microorganisms were found in the form of a net in the aeration tank, it was called as flox. Our hey flox bilak, we have sent the flox into a sedimentation tank. This time what we have disposed is the liquid of the sedimentation tank. Aru ami clean ki korilu solid substance kini ami we have tried to clean. So this solid substance, it is called as ki activated sludge. Activated sludge was sent into something called as anaerobic sludge digester. Anaerobic sludge digester ki asile anaerobic microorganisms asile tahantor kam ki asile to kill the aerobic organism that was present, and ultimately the liquid that is left out is now considered to be clean and it is disposed, right? Another thing that you need to remember is jete ei process to soli ase anaerobic sludge digester jete kam kini kori ase tetia ki hoy some type of gas is also synthesized. Some type of gas evolves which gives a foul smell. So during this process kisuman dhoronor gas ulabo aru hei karone ei process tu jeta soli thakibo ami kiba ta beya gundho pam, that is what is called as a foul smell. Ei beya gundho tu ami kiho karone pam, because of the gas that has been generated in the process, and this is what is called as biogas, right? So ultimately within this process kisuman biogas formation also will take place, right? And whenever we are talking about biogas, generally we are talking about the presence of methane in it, right? Biogas at bahut belek belek dhoron bostu thakibo ki ki thakibo, methane thakibo pare, carbon dioxide thakibo pare, H2S thakibo pare, hydrogen thakibo pare, kintu maximum quantity ki hor thakibo obviously of methane, and this is what we are talking about. This biogas generally consists of ki methane, carbon dioxide, H2S, etc. And we know H2S generally jot thake tate birat beshi beya gundhay. So this is all about sewage treatment, right? Next ami jehetu biogas er kotha kore aso, so we need to know some informations about biogas. They are also called as ki fuel gas. They contain ki methane, around 50 to 70% methane thake, right? আৰু কাৰ্বন ডাই অক্সাইড থাকিব অৰাউণ্ড 30-40%. Apart from these two, they also have traces of H2S, H2, etc. Biogas is a renewable source of energy. Renewable, non-renewable, I think we understand. Another point is, biogas is also obtained from some animal, obtained from animal waste, plant waste, animal excreta, etc. Right? And whenever we talk about animal excreta, we generally remember about what? Cow dung. Aro cow dung or prajun to gas ulai. That is what is called as gobar gas. Lastly, biogas production is helped by a type of bacteria that is called as methanogens. Right? Methanogens bila ki hoy? Anaerobic bacteria. So these are the informations about biogas. So what we have learned today is, we have talked about the most important treatment, that is called as the sea waste treatment, that was very important in this lesson, right? So sea waste treatment, we had an idea, and while we are sewage has been treated, a particular type of gas is also evolved, and that gas is what is called as biogas. Apart from this gas, we have to always talk about something called as gobar gas, and gobar gas is something that is obtained from the cow dung, right? Cow dung keneke koribo je anaerobic digestion of the cow dung is tetiahole ki huma eta gas produce koribo tak ami ki boli kon gobar gas. Next is biogas kole we have to remember the contribution of methanogens also. What is methanogens? Methane producing bacteria are called as methanogens. So methanogens upor question ahe ar plus kure they are a type of aerobic bacteria ne anaerobic bacteria. So they are a type of anaerobic bacteria. So up till here we have completed the lesson microbes in human welfare. Right? So different role of microbes we have discussed, positive roles we have discussed koilo household products or right. Next, industrial products form koribole microorganism or role ki. What is the role of microorganisms in sea waste treatment, in for the production of biogas? Next, microorganisms as biocontrol, microorganisms as fertilizers or biofertilizer also. So this is all about the contents. Right. So if you have any doubts, we can discuss, right? Kiba doubts asa jodi khuda, or maybe you read the lesson properly and then you can bring the doubts in the next class. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to discuss certain types of questions as usual. No, I mean protect lesson or episode, what we do is we try to discuss certain type of questions so that we have an idea what is the type of question that is asked from this lesson. Similarly for this chapter also we'll be discussing certain type of questions. Now se kenekwa questions ahe, just to have an idea, no, the key question no ahe yabra. Sea waste treatment to kaha questions ahe de, sea waste treatment to bhalke porhiba. So certain type of questions. Okay, the first question that has been asked is gases produced during So gases produced in anaerobic slash digester. অলপ আগতে আমি কৈছো ন, সো ৱাট আৰ দ্য টাইপ অফ গেছেছ দেট আৰ প্ৰডিউচ ইন এনএৰোবিক শ্লাছ ডাইজেষ্টাৰ। উই আৰ নট গোইং টু ৰাইট দ্য অপশ্যনছ, উই আৰ গোইং টু ৰাইট দ্য আনচাৰ ডিৰেক্টলি। সো কি কি গেছ আছিলে? মিথেইন, CO2, H2S। জেনেৰেলি উই টক এবাউট দিজ থ্ৰী গেছেছ। সেকেণ্ড কুৱেশ্যন ইজ উই হেভ টকড এবাউট সামথিং কল্ড এজ BOD, ন, হাই value of BOD indicates, right? আমি কি কৈছিলো যে BODটো আমি মেজাৰ কৰোঁ কিহৰ কাৰণে মেজাৰ কৰোঁ, জাষ্ট টু চি ৱেডাৰ দেট ৱাটাৰ ইজ পলিউটেড অৰ নট, ৰাইট? পলিউশ্যন বেছি আছে নে কম আছে সেই বস্তুটো চাবলৈ হ'লে আমি কি মেজাৰ কৰোঁ, আমি BODটো তাৰ ষ্টাডি কৰোঁ। সো হাই ভেলু অফ BOD ইণ্ডিকেটছ, কি ইণ্ডিকেট কৰে? Consumption of organic matter in water is high by the microbes. This is the first option. Second option is water is pure. Third option is water is highly polluted. Can anyone give me the answer? And the last is water is less polluted. Right? So the question has been asked about BOD. এটা ৱাটাৰ চেম্পলৰ যদি BOD লেভেলটো হাই হৈ আছে, ৱাট উই ন' এবাউট দ্য ৱাটাৰ ইজ, উই আৰ টকিং এবাউট পলিউশ্যন অবভিয়াছলি, চ' ৱেডাৰ দ্য ৱাটাৰ ইজ হাইলি পলিউটেড নে দ্য ৱাটাৰ ইজ লেছ পলিউটেড। ৱেন এভাৰ BOD ইজ হাই, দ্য ৱাটাৰ ইজ হাইলি পলিউটেড। দ্য থাৰ্ড কুৱেশ্যন, দ্য গাটছ অফ কাউ, গাটছ মানে ষ্টমাক, and buffalo possess option A. We know guts of cow and buffalo, whenever we talk about them, we remember the presence of a certain type of microorganism inside it. So the question has been asked that what is the type of microorganism found in the guts of cows and buffaloes? Ki paiba janune? Cyanobacteria, fucus species, chlorella, and number 3 is methanogens. So out of this, what would be the answer? Obviously methanogens would be the correct answer. Next question. The fourth question is, a river with an inflow, question to bhalke porhiba, with an inflow of domestic sewage rich in organic waste may result in. So we are talking about a river. Hey, river khonot ki porise je domestic sewage bilakor flow hoise into that river. So the question is, what will happen to that river, right? And the options that are given are drying of the river, very soon due to algal bloom, increased population of aquatic food web organisms, and increased production of fish or death of fish due to lack of oxygen. So these are the options that are given. A river with an inflow of domestic sewage rich in organic waste may result in. So here river khonor ultimately ki hobo? Will the river dry up or will it increase or aquatic food web organisms will occur? Population increase koribo nike? Neither production of fish will increase, neither all the fish that is present in that water will die off. Obviously the fourth option is the correct answer, because when we are talking about this domestic sewage running into the water without treatment, that are like তার অক্সিজেন কন্টেন্ট বিলাক কমি যাব, এন্ড এজ এ রিজাল্ট দ্য একুয়েটিক অর্গানিজমস উড ডাই অফ. নেক্সট, bacterium used extensively as biopesticide. So there are various types of bacteria, or names of bacteria are given. For example, Bacillus subtilis, this is also a bacteria. Streptococcus lactis, এইবিলাক সব কি হয়? Bacteria. Bacillus thuringiensis, আর D is Lactobacillus. So we are talking about biopesticide. Biopesticide is up here, we know. We have talked about something called as BT, and one plant that is BT cotton. So answer would be BT. Next, question number 6. Terramycin, all of the points of discuss kariso, is got from. You have to remember. So obviously we know Streptomyces, kintu species to janibo leibo. Streptomyces gracious. Streptomyces veningelli. Streptomyces ramosus. So এনেকুৱা ধৰণৰ questions আমি পঢ়িব লাগিব. So we know we are talking about Streptomyces ramosus. So this is a question just to give an idea that অকল genus to পঢ়িলে নহ'ব, even the species name is very important in this lesson. Next, we have talked about distillation, alcoholic drinks formed because of distillation, or alcoholic drinks produced without distillation. So a question about distillation that has been asked. Distillation of wine is necessary. Distillation of wine is necessary as or because, right? There are so many options that are given. We'll write the answer as it prevents further fermentation and spoiling of wine. And that is the reason why distillation process is important. Zarenege fermentation process to hoi hoi natake. Basic fermentation hole ki hobo? That will lead to the spoilers of the food. Next question that is asked is vitamin that increases during curd formation. And whenever we are talking about curd formation, we talk about vitamin B12. A question about antibiotics falls about antibiotics. You have to choose the correct option. Option A cures all diseases. Option B, it is something that is produced by microorganisms, right? It is coined by Waksman. And the fourth option was none. So what is false about antibiotics? That it cannot cure all the different types of diseases. So out of these options, the option that we are left out is it does not cure all types of diseases. And the last question. It is asked about BGA. What is BGA? Blue green algae or cyanobacteria is chiefly used as fertilizers in wheat field, paddy field, gram field, in mustard field. So a question about blue green algae or cyanobacteria has also been asked. So BGA or cyanobacteria, we have given the examples of BGA, right? We have talked about examples like Anabina oscillataria, right? Next, we have talked about something called as Oloscira. And what I have said is, generally, if you talk about the oscillataria or you talk about Anabina, if you talk about oscillataria and if you talk about Oloscira, these are the type of microorganisms or cyanobacteria that increases the fertility in the paddy field. So whenever such type of a question is given, we'll be always left with the option that is paddy field. So we have almost discussed around 10 questions from this chapter, and now we have an idea that what is the type of question that has been asked from this chapter, right? So we have completed this chapter, and in the next class we'll be starting with another or new chapter. Thank you for today.